Hi, this is Osvaldo. We're here in Band Music. And we are with Philip Dostovsky here in Macedonia, one of the activists, the marijuana activist and patient also, no?
Yeah.
For hemp oil?
More for patients than marijuana. I mean, it started with patients, not with activism about legalizing for recreational use.
But you are also a patient, no?
Yes, yes. I had Hodgkin's lymphoma.
So, patient and activist, Philip. So, tell us a little bit about the situation in Macedonia regarding...
I must interrupt you. I'm a patient and a doctor for myself, not only patient. Okay, so, the question.
The situation in Macedonia, medical marijuana, recreational marijuana...
both are forbidden. Should I look at the camera or at you? Okay, it's better. Both are forbidden. The thing is, with medical marijuana, the things took off, I don't know, 3 or 4 years ago. Everybody is using it. I mean, first, a lot of the public was skeptical about it, but because it's the best marketing words, you know, the word. When somebody gets results, tells another sick person.
Word of mouth.
Yeah, word of mouth. So this is the best marketing. And for medical marijuana, it's different. And also for recreational, now the public opinion, it's not so like, oh, look at those junkies. It's more like, it's more okay than it used to be, but still it's not completely okay. But
so how did this start, the marijuana, medical marijuana movement here in
Medical marijuana movement, like, I cannot say that I was the first one, because many people have seen Rick Simpson before, but maybe me and my friends, not just me, were the first one that spoke it publicly, you know, more publicly. We went on TV and, you know, admitted publicly, stuff like that. On our, how do you say it, we were surprised that nothing happened to us in terms of beliefs and stuff like that. I mean, not ever. No one brought that question up. As I told you in the interview before, the things took off maybe 2012 or 13. More publicly, before that, I mean, people were making it, the weed was cheap. Now the weed is 10 times more expensive, so now it's a problem. Before it was a problem because the public was skeptical, now it's a problem because we don't have material. And it's still illegal, I mean, people go to jail for small amounts.
Like, so they brought the weed from Albania?
Before, yeah, I mean, still. Most of the weed that comes in Macedonia comes from Albania. As I told you, it was like 1 kilo was maybe 500 euros. If you don't know people, if you know, maybe you can find it even cheaper. And that's why no one bothered to grow in Macedonia. So when this thing with Lazarat happened, so there is not weed anymore like it used to be. Here no one knows how to grow because of that. We had very cheap weed, no one bothered to grow, and now we don't have any weed. And people are starting to grow. For the last 2 years, people are starting to grow, but mostly patients. Because because also they, when are buying the oil, you know, there's a lot of scammers and shady people, and they don't get quality oil, so... Now it's a breaking point, I mean, these 2 or 3 years.
So you were telling me there's a new law happening in Macedonia?
The new law is happening at this moment. I mean, they are writing the new law. But it's more like copy-paste from Croatia and from other ex-Yugoslav republics, which they admitted that THC has some medicine properties, but still they are not admitting, you know, all the way. They want to use it for like they're using Sativex in Western Europe, maybe for vomiting when you receive chemotherapy and for some patients with with MS. Many of the people who have other diseases, which THC can help, they are not in the patient list who can receive. So the law is, it's one step forward, but it's a very small step. Mm-hmm. We are not satisfied with the law. I mean, so like this.
How much is a gram here in the street?
It used to be 3 grams. Used to be 5 euros. Now 1 gram is 20 euros.
20 euros for one.
You can find it for cheaper, but if you find good weed, it's something like this. 20 euros, maybe a little less, like 17. But it's around that price.
And for our Canadian friends that want to come to Macedonia, what happens if they a cop finds them smoking a joint?
For Macedonians, it's like you will go to. You will go to police station, maybe you can spend one night, but it's not, it's criminal offense, but they usually let you you must pay money, like a fine. Mm-hmm. For Canadian, they will empty your wallet, I think, but you will not have, more problems than that.
Uh-huh.
And for every foreigner, because you know that there is no purpose. They now they know that, because you know you can find everywhere with what he's going to do to you. I mean. But he will see you as a bag of money. You know, so.
So this new government, or
so, because no one catch you with this, we are maybe 300 or 500 euros richer. So.
So this government also was found doing some fraud, no?
I wouldn't speak about
it. No, okay.
We can speak in another interview, but I must explain to you the situation, uh-huh. Okay? But okay. I will tell you this, I will send you links and everything, you'll understand.
Okay.
I can tell you now why, because if I speak about this, then probably tomorrow they will arrest me. Because I will tell you one, I forgot to tell you about this case with Sokili. Mm-hmm. There is a guy here who was, long time ago, he was the one of the first people that were publicly known that use heroin and opiates, you know, methadone, stuff like this. And there is very famous movie from the 80s, in Macedonian movie, where he was, he's an actor, you know, so mm-hmm. he was doing a character that is in jail, but also this character in the movie is drug addict, you know, so uh-huh. it was easy for him to act, yeah, okay. So this was in the 80s, so this guy is like famous actor, and whole Macedonia loves him. His name is Kirill Pop Christov. I will show you on Facebook, and he was arrested with a grow operation at his home, but he was sick. He had a tumor on his bones, you know, like in the back. So half of the public, this guy, we say that he did the Jesus job for medical marijuana in Macedonia, because he was arrested. He was arrested maybe 200 times before with heroin and with weed, but as a user, not as a dealer, you know.
Uh-huh.
And the thing is, he started growing for himself because he was sick. 2 days before they arrested him, he was on the main square, you know, eating shit about this Skopje project 2014.
Uh-huh.
2 days after his public performance about this fucked up project, he was arrested and he went to jail, and in jail they saw that he really has a tumor, and they put him in hospital for an operation, and they let him at home in, what do you say, home prison?
Uh-huh.
You have this, you know,
home arrest?
Yeah, because he is sick, you know, he cannot, because here the jails are in very, very, healthy guy can die from sickness there. So he was arrested, as I told you, 2 days after he was speaking negatively about the government. I was helping him after he was arrested. He went home after the operation, so I was making him oil also at home. That was also illegal because I didn't have permission to go at his home because he's in home jail. Mm. And now he's immigrated to Ecuador. Now he's healthy and living there and growing wheat. So he posts on Facebook all the time. So this is why I... Ah, and this guy in the movie, his name was Jesus. You know, in the movie. And after they arrested him, after 20 years with the wheat, he was spending the jail time in the same cell that they were filming the movie, you know? And we say that he did the, like, Jesus job, you know, all the on his back. Uh-huh. Because after his arrest, that was the point where medical marijuana went really publicly. And after that, the government didn't arrest anybody for medical marijuana because they saw the, you know, the response from the public, yeah. So that's why also we don't have problems.
And what do you think is the future of medical marijuana now in Macedonia?
I think as medical marijuana, it has very great future, bright future, but that don't mean that will be legal. The thing is, everybody knows and use it, so this is bright future, and it's happening now. And what will government do about it, I don't know.
Will be more tolerated, maybe.
In terms of medical marijuana, I think no one cares if it's tolerated. If your life depends on it, I mean, from jail you can come back, from the graveyard you cannot come back, right? So the future is great. I mean, the present now is great.
Cool.
Just the government doesn't know still about it.
Okay,
so
well,
I think this is it.
Thank you for the interview. Anything else you want to add to our friends?
I want to add to you, just cut this thing about the government until we arrange something. You know, you can do it. So.